Is it clear? So now let's do what? On click. Now we have to do what? On click of the image. That means when the user will upload the image. What we need to do? We have to upload the image. And let's preview the way Facebook is doing. Are you getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now what we have to do? We are done with our HTML. We are done with our CSS. Now our task is what? JavaScript. That means who can work on click? JavaScript. So now the logic starts. We have to create a new block. Are you getting the point?
Yes, sir.
So now what we have to do? We have to write a function. Where we need to write? In our JavaScript. So we have two options. Either jQuery or document object. Now, when we click here on image tag, so this, okay, now we have another thing. We need to study one more thing here. We need to understand click and change. What is click? Click is an event. Can I say that?
Yes.
What are the events? Like single click, double click, right click, keyboard, on key up, on key press. These are what? These are the input events. Whenever these are the input events used by us, whenever you are on any particular web page, we perform such kind of operations with the application like Android and iOS. Now we have a mouse over, hand over, swipe left, swipe right. These are the new events. So one event we are very much familiar. The event is what? Click. On click, you understand on click. But now tell me. Shall we use on click here on the image upload also? Yes or no? If yes, then why? And if no, also why? What is our task? Now our task is, I'm asking the question to you, which event shall we use? Shall we use the on click event for the image upload also? If the answer is no, then why? Sumit? Which method we are going to use now here? Where we will use on input type is equal to file. Which method we are using? On change. And on change now here we will call a function. Okay, do you know how to call a function? By function name, upload or suppose post image, and we put what? Curly parentheses. What does it mean? The meaning is that we are calling a function. And where this function is available? On JavaScript. So let's go to the one.js, post here and post. Now here we are writing what? Posting a post image. Can I say like this? Okay, so let's write hello world, console.log, post image logic comes here. So now let's check this. Open a developer tool. If I select an image from the desktop, there is no image. Let me take one image. Are you getting the point? So whenever we are uploading an image, right now we have not done any logic. I just wanted to show you that our method is properly getting called. Okay? So once you are done with this, now we need to write and we need to handle the logic. How to work with image. Let's do what now here? can I access the image element?
Yes, sir.
Can I access the image element?
Yes, sir. For your kind information, if I can access the this text box, if I can access this button element, can I access this element?
Yes.
So what's it? What is the easier way to access any element? By ID. So let's go to our HTML and let's provide here ID. What is the ID? Let's suppose we are giving. Let's suppose file ID 1. Can I write like this? Let's follow the camel case convention since it is a variable. So now let's go to our developer console, refresh the page, and can I write here document dot query selector? Do you know this?
Yes.
Now what shall I write here? Okay. Now on change type is equal to what? File. Now let's suppose okay, so in this way, where we will access this in the in our JS. So let's do what? Let's file reference is equal to what? Document dot get. Has what? File ID 1. And can I print this here? Let's print this first. Let's go here and refresh the page. Still, we are in a progress. We are not done completely. 1.js. If I change here an image, what is happening? We are this line. Now we are this line. Okay. Now can I access the file reference? File reference dot files. Okay. Now here, come here. What is the value of the file reference?
When we are typing file reference, what is returning? The element. Hello, are you getting my point?
Now just think now here,
when you access the input box, how do you read the value?
Dot
value.
Dot value. Yes or no?
Yes.
Dot value in normal document object.
Now the point is, when you are uploading the image, how will you read the value? Okay, so this is our input element. This is the reference of this input element.
And what is the value inside this? File ref dot files. Because we are uploading a file. So now, which attribute we are using? Files. So this attribute holds all the files which have been uploaded by the user. Is it clear? So now,
but this one is returning what? File list. Why so?
File ref dot files 0. So now you can see that we got what? The file object. The file which has been uploaded by the user. Okay. Now let me revise one more time here. When we write here file ref dot files. Why so? It is returning a list.
Why? Because many a website give you an option to select more than one image at a time. Have you uploaded image?
Yes.
Multiple images one at a time?
Yes.
So that's why this is the property files. It returns what? It is the option to you. How many images you want to upload.
Okay. So how many images right now we are uploading?
One.
So how to access that element?
How do we are accessing the individual image? Directly. by using the only first element. Why? Because we are uploading only one image. Is it clear? So how we are doing this? How we are trying to understand this? Sir, when there is a text box, how do you read the value? Using dot value. When there is a input text file, how do you read the value? Dot files.
Why dot files? Because user can upload multiple images. But since we are only allowing only one image to be uploaded, how to access that? Zero. So if you are allowing multiple upload, then we have to use what? A for loop. Is it clear? Okay. So let me print this value for the time being. File ref dot. Can I write here? Let upload file is equal to what? File reference dot dot files. Under this, what we are using? Zero. I hope you understand this. Or instead of file reference, can I write file element so that you can better relate? Is it clear? Is it clear? Hello. Now, the next important thing which I was talking a bit earlier. What our image understands. So this is, can I say that this is the image, uploaded image?
Yes.
Upload file variable is refer what? The uploaded image. Now, what we have to do? Somehow we have to link.
Somehow, let's do what? Let's change this image.
Let's not add another block. Let's do what?
Let's change the image. Can I change this image?
Yes.
Can I change this image?
Yes. If I need to change this image, what I have to do?
Change the
we have to change the source. Are you getting my point? So we have to access this image element and we have to change the source. And there is another truth about the source is what? It understands only URL.
Okay, but how does, but if we right now open the console, upload a image, how does it look? If I upload the image, how does it look? It looks a JSON object.
Or actually your file is what? It's a binary file. Okay, isn't it? It's a binary file. But your program, but your SRC attribute, what does it understand? URL.
So now we will know there is a method in our application, in our JavaScript, that converts your file into what? That converts your file object into what? URL. URL dot create object URL. Upload file as URL. So do you understand this? So this line is very important.
This line is very important. What we are doing? We are converting our uploaded file into what? Into a valid URL. Do you understand why we are doing this? Why we are doing this? Because image tag understands what? SRC. What does the SRC understands? URL. SRC has to be a valid URL. That's why we have went to the Facebook, Twitter and LinkedIn to show you. What is the value of the SRC? The value of the SRC is what?
URL. A proper HTTP URL. So now,
we have uploaded the image. We have accessed the image. Now we have converted the image into what?
URL
also. Now what we have to do?
Now we have to do what?
Can I change this image? Can I change this image?
Yes.
So let's do what?
If I write here document dot query selector, can I write like this? And can I write image? Now tell me, in our HTML, how many images had been used?
One.
And the query selector returns how many elements? Only one. So can I write that it's an image element? Now can I, if it is an element, and we know that every element has how many attributes?
Name, ID.
But do we need to change all those? No. Here what we need to change? Image element dot src is equal to what? Upload file as URL. Okay, this we are doing what? Temporary operation we are doing. What? Changing the existing image. This is the temporary operation. So if, let's see now the output. If the things go properly, what will happen? If I upload the image, the image has been uploaded, and what we have done? We have successfully changed the existing image. But do we require this? What we need to do? We need to do what? We need to add a new block. Can you add a new block?
Yes.
And then can we change the image?
Yes.
So are you getting the point?
Yes.
So how many things we have learned?
First of all, image tag, img tag, in the img tag, src attribute. This is very important. What does the src attribute stand? Understand? Then how to make this image properly aligned into a one container. That is the second thing. Third thing what you learned? How to upload an image. And how to make that button beautiful also. And how to access the file and convert that file into what? Proper URL.
I hope so you are getting the point. Why we have done this line, you have to understand this.
Is there any doubt? Why we are doing this? Because we need to do what? We have to convert our uploaded image into what? And why we are doing this? Because our image doesn't understand file directly. He understands what? URL.
Okay, that's enough. Now I am commenting the temporary operation. Now here what we need to do? Let's clone. Let's add a new block. Can we add a block?
Yes.
Okay, so do you know? So if I need to add a new block, where I have to go? Okay. If I need, that means this is our reference block.
So what I have to do? We have to make a clone of this. Can I say that?
Yes.
Okay.
So I hope that now you people are familiar with the clone, familiar with the traversing. To simplify my life, what I am doing? Image reference. Okay. Image reference block ID. Can I give a name like this? So what I have to do? I have to make a clone of this. So where's what I will do here? Document dot query selector. Now here I will write what? Has image block reference ID. So can I write here image reference? Can I write like this? Now can I use this? No, I will not use this. I have to make a clone of this. Image reference. So can I write let new image block is equal to what? Dot Okay, is it clear? Now what we have to do? So this is a new block is available. So all together a new block will be created. But now what we have to do? Shall I run the program now? Now what we have to do? We have to upload, we have to attach with what? Attach the new block with parent. So do you have the reference of the parent? Who is the parent? Block parent. So can I reference this? Let parent is equal to what? Document selector. What we can do here? Is it clear? Now what we have to do? Parent dot insert before, and what we have to use here? New image block, and then what we have to use? Is it clear? So what we have done?
We have made a clone of a new node. By using clone, we have created a new block, and we have added that block as a
first child. So now if I refresh the page, image, and what I will do here? Whenever we are doing what? We are adding a new image. So let's download few images. Now if you go here and select an image from the download section, can you see that we are able to upload the image now? So whenever we are changing, uploading an image, what is happening? A new block is getting created. But what is the problem? Same. So we, whatever the work we have done, we have not applied here. We have to do what? We have to change the source. So now can you change the source here? So where we have to work? Into our new block. What we have to do with the new block? We have to change the source of the image. Change the source of the image of a new block. So now, but to access the image, what we have to do now? We have to travel. Hello?
Yes.
What we have to do? We have to travel. Because this is a reference to new block. So to travel here, what we have to do? Children. The first children, and then again children. So what I will write here? New image block dot children. So it will return what? So this one returns the div. But again I have to go where? Inside the. So again I have to use what? And now we can assign here the value what? Upload file as URL. But here we have to write what? Dot src. Change the source of image new block. Do we need to put a semicolon? Yes. Now if you go here, if you go to the desktop again, a new image has been uploaded. And now you can go and okay, now Okay.